Which email service should I use? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. AskLeo is supported in large part by its patrons. If you'd like to become a patron and get access to an ad-free experience on AskLeo or exclusive content, visit askleo.com/patron to learn more. Let's dive right into the question. I'm wanting to create and use a new email account to be used primarily as an address for maintaining professional connections after I retire from my current job. Ideally, the new address will be independent of an internet service provider and, as much as reasonably possible, secure and respectful of privacy. Many people these days use Gmail. I am considering an Outlook.com address. My question, do you have any advice and or any factors I may want to consider when choosing and setting up this email account slash service? Indeed, I do. When it comes to email, I have lots of opinions. I'm going to outline three specific approaches you can take. So the criteria that I want you to consider and that you've mentioned include, what kind of support will be there if you run into trouble? What kind of privacy will be offered? What's the cost? And how long will it be available? All of those need to factor into the decision. Naturally, not choosing your ISP is a very good choice. I've definitely run into very concerned individuals who, when they've moved, for example, to a new neighborhood, and their ISP that they had at the old neighborhood is no longer available at their new neighborhood, their email address is gone. There are usually no solutions that provide them a way to keep the old email address at the old ISP and when they move out of range or out of that ISP's service area. So good on you for recognizing that and making sure not to use the email address provided by your ISP. Now, the most flexible solution, the one that will last the longest, and the one that I personally happen to use, is to own your own domain. Like I own askleo.com. As long as I continue to own askleo.com, every email address on that domain is under my control. Now, when it comes to actually implementing the sending and the receiving and the processing of email, you have lots of choices. You can, well, at one extreme, you can set up your own mail server. That's probably not something most people want to consider. More commonly, the registrar from which you purchase the domain may offer email services right then and there, usually for an extra fee. But that way, your email address at your own domain is yours to do with what you will, and the email will be processed by that third party, by your registrar. As long as you keep the ownership up to date, as long as you continue to renew your ownership of that domain, that email address or all of the email addresses are yours for life, effectively. So that is one approach. Indeed, it costs money. You end up registering your domain, which costs some number of dollars a year, and you may end up paying for some email service on top of that. There's an approach, and again, it's the approach that I actually use, is to route the email through a third-party email processor that offers it for free. Free sounds a lot like Gmail. And indeed, when you send email to leo@askleo.com, it's actually Gmail at the back end that's processing the email for me for free. When I send email that's coming from leo@askleo.com, it's being sent through a Gmail account. For the most part, you wouldn't know to look at it unless you knew to look at some of the hidden headers. And it's great that they're there, but the point is that I didn't have to do anything. I'm doing all of this through my Gmail web interface. Now, the reason that I really, really like this approach is that, again, I own the domain. I can change any of this at a moment's notice if, for some reason, I lost my Gmail account. I would lose all access to my Gmail email address. But at the domain level, the askleo.com level, I could quickly say, oh, let's start processing my email using outlook.com. instead of gmail.com, and I'd be back in business almost immediately. Or I could say, you know what, this Gmail thing was working out great, but now it's time to take it back to the registrar and have somebody with some support give me help managing my email. So that's my number one recommendation for most, that if you have the ability, if you have the interest, and if you've got a little bit of technical ability, actually owning your own domain is the most robust solution that gives you the most control for the longest time. Now, the next solution down are what I would call paid email services. There are a lot of them out there. I prefer paid email services for anything that's super important because you have somebody to go to. You have help. The email service that I actually have used and continue to use and pay for is ProtonMail. Now, ProtonMail's expertise is not really focused on providing paid email. Their claim to fame is all about privacy and encryption, two things that you mentioned were important to you. They are based in Switzerland. They have a free service that you can use to try it out. It has some limitations on the amount of email you can send and the amount of email that you can save, but it'll give you a feel for the service and whether or not it's right for you. If you then want to, you can pay to get more service, better support, and have those limitations lifted. As a kind of a combination of what I've talked about so far, I have another domain on which I have another email address, but I have it processed by ProtonMail. That is one of the options for paying customers. Just like I could have askleo.com's email processed by gmail.com, I have this other domain being processed by ProtonMail. I log into my ProtonMail account, and email received for and sent by that account are all handled by ProtonMail. They also have some additional privacy-centric services like a VPN and a cloud storage, but for paid email services, that's typically where I'm sending people these days. There are many others, and if ProtonMail is not for you, I would encourage you to look around some. And of course, there's free email. The huge, huge catch with free email services, and this goes for both Gmail and for Outlook.com, is that there is little to no support. It looks like they're going to be around for a while. I'm not really worried about losing an email address anymore if I've got an email address on either of those two services. Let's face it, I've got a 20 or 25 year old Hotmail email address that is still working and still being serviced by Outlook.com. The big issue is the lack of support. If something happens on that account, if something happens, I lose the account, it gets hacked or whatever, I have no one to turn to. And that's a problem in my opinion. But it's a problem that many people are willing to live with and protect themselves by making sure to do security correctly on those accounts and to back up the contents of those email accounts on an ongoing basis. That's totally free. Those are two services that, yeah, I'd consider. I would consider Gmail probably first, mostly because Gmail's spam filter seems to be the best in the industry today and has been for some time. Outlook, I know they're working on it, but it still isn't up to par. It's a fine email service if you don't mind things changing a fair amount. And of course, if you have a Windows 10 PC and are using a Microsoft account to log into that PC, you already have an Outlook.com account because that's what it is. Regardless of which solution you end up choosing, I have to reiterate the importance of backing up your email. So many people don't. And so many people are sorry when something happens, be it an account hack, a service that disappears, or something else like simply deleting an email you didn't mean to delete. Backing up your email on a regular basis is, in my opinion, critical for a service that we all rely on so heavily. If you'd like more information like this along these lines, consider subscribing to Confident Computing, my weekly email newsletter that comes out and covers topics like this, Windows, internet security, email, and more. Visit askleo.com/newsletter to learn more about Confident Computing. I hope this was helpful. For updates, for related links, for comments, and more, visit askleo.com/134489. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.